So joining us on the show today, all the way from KwaMashu, Natal, 12 kilometres north of Durban, is an award-winning poetic lyricist and hip-hop artist. He released his third studio album, Cebisa, in 2018, and has just received a SAMA nomination for Best Remix of the Year for his song, Sebentin. Award-winning and super-talented poetic hip-hop artist, Zakwe.
If my balls was easy, be gone for a slain. I'm bowling easy with guns at the game. If I didn't see none, I'd go hold up. Wait, now you know me better. I don't hold it back. I'm like a stormy weather. Try to stop me never. Now the story teller. I'm a golden setter. Wine is on the setter. Hold up. Wait, who does it better? Yes, son, I know my care. I can't send the last letter. Spend the last letter. Now I'm never clever. Golden mind just ever. Go and I'ma get him. This is my time.
Wow, that was amazing! I love that you're allowed to be topless, but I'm not. Welcome to the show, Zakwe,
so
finally.
Much. Thank you
and
so
congratulations
much.
On your SAMA nomination.
Thank you so much.
I mean, I think awards are really important because yeah. it shows respect of your peers
yeah,
and the yeah. value of your fans.
Yeah,
what does it mean to you? And I mean, are you hoping to win?
It means a lot to me, you know. I really wanted the best hip-hop album, but it's fine, you know what I mean? This means a lot to me. And if I win it, it's going to be so much crazier, especially because it's going to be dedicated to Pro Kid and HP, RIP to the Kings, you know. So
were you very close to them?
I was very close, you know, especially when the time of death was very close, you know. So
really?
Yeah. But life goes on. Yeah,
it does.
Yeah.
So you're from KwaMashu.
Yeah.
In Natal.
Yeah.
There's parts of Natal that just literally look like it was how God made the world,
yeah.
just because it's so lush and so green. What was it like growing up in KwaMashu?
Oh, it was amazing, you know. I grew up in an era where talent was very nurtured, you know what I mean? There's a lot of artists that I grew up with from KwaMashu, you know. Your Destruction Boys, Dladla Mshunqisi, Mzulu, Duncan, you
Why
know what I mean?
All from that particular area? I mean, what was it like? That's what it bred, basically.
Like I said, like there's an art center called KCAP in KwaMashu. That's like where most of us actually built our talent from, you know, from the music side to the acting side and whatnot, you know. So I think it played a huge role. So shout out to Babu Mhlongo. Yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Now, I know it doesn't look like it, but I'm a huge hip hop fan.
Yeah.
Huge. I love rap. I love hip hop. And what I do love about it is rap artists' ability to use words as social commentary, but also to almost be percussion.
Yeah.
Like your rhythm when you rap is percussive. I think it's beautiful.
Yeah.
Are there different kinds of rap that you like when you like how do you when you get into it? Is it just a natural flow?
Yeah.
Or is it a conscious beat that you work on with the words?
Yeah. I think, first of all, as a rapper, I think all of us as rappers, as MCs, we should be poets. If you are a rapper, you are a poet, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just that you're now taking your poetry and putting it into a beat, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because that's how I started, you know?
Yeah.
I started as a poet, attending hip-hop shows, just being a fan, and then I started getting beats and started recording, started doing freestyles and whatnot, you know? Yeah, yeah. So that's how we actually start and pay our dues. Yeah.
I want to know a little bit more about your poetry because I know it focuses a lot on Ikasi.
Yeah.
But, you know, when we think of poets, we don't think of, you know, big...
Yeah.
these big dudes.
Yeah.
Like, are you a natural romantic? And, like, how does your poetry span? Like, how did you start it? And obviously, because maybe it didn't start off as being hip-hop, but, like, how did your poetry start?
I've always been that type of dear Dolly guy, you know. Yeah. Each and every time.
That's so cute.
Each and everything, each and every time something very special happens to me, I write about it. And then I realized, I'm actually rhyming when doing this, yeah. You know. That's when I put my pen, my thoughts to the paper, yeah. And then went to studio, started recording. I think it was in 2004, 3, if I'm not mistaken. And then that's when I realized, no, the voice is there, you know what I mean? The delivery is there. So yeah, man, that's how it all went down from 2003 when I was in high school.
When people ask you to define or describe yourself, you say that you're a very reserved person.
Yeah.
In what way?
Like I said, I've always been the dear Dolly type of guy, you know, and then until I realized that I don't want to talk too much, I'd rather speak through the music, you know, that's how it all came about. So I've always been very reserved until I realized, no, there's a lot that I want to say, but I just can't talk. Yeah. So I just put it through the music and then let the masses hear what I'm saying. Yeah.
If I have to think of three international hip hop artists that... Yeah. I know for a fact are probably some of the most intelligent men in the world. Yeah. It's Jay-Z, Eminem, Snoop Dogg. They're geniuses.
Yeah.
They're lyrical geniuses.
True,
but you are super smart and you come from a seriously academic family.
Yeah.
Was there pressure to follow through with being an academic? So I think your dad just finished his second doctorate or what was it, master's?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
He just finished his second doctorate. It was very tough, to be honest, you know, because I mean, I left school and then went to pursue my career in hip hop. I had to make it. There was no other choice.
You had no choice.
There was no other choice.
You didn't want a doctor's hand, I told you so.
Yeah, man. So I'm very excited about my life right now. And then to see that my parents are actually celebrating my life right now, you know, they're very proud of me, although I didn't take the academic route, but they're very happy with what I am today.
And especially that your hip-hop has got a social responsible kind of flow to it, and you're not exactly like pouring champagne all over booties.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
I know, no problem. It's accepted in a way if you grew up that way, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, I grew up in a place where it's all about letting people know where you come from, letting talking about social issues and whatnot, you know.
Yeah.
So that's my era of hip-hop.
So, obviously today is Tuesday, so it's our Tuesday cook-along.
Yeah.
How good are you in the kitchen?
Am
I going to be doing the cooking and you're going to be doing the singing?
Let me just say 50%. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. You won't be hungry when I'm around.
Do you like burgers?
I love burgers.
Okay,
I
good. Well, we've got three coming your way. We're very, very
perfect.
Happy to have you here.
Thank you so much for being here.
And we'll be in the kitchen in just a while. So let's face it, there really isn't anything in the world quite so satisfying as your first bite of a rich, juicy, I'm joking, hamburger. Don't believe us. After the break, we celebrate International Burger Day by showing you just how you can make your very own burger for dinner tonight.